Hey everyone, Reid, Henrichs with Valor Ridge. Purpose of the video today is to have a reality check, have an honest conversation with yourself about what you need when it comes to defending yourself and your family. Let's go ahead and get started. Folks, if you'd watched the channel for a while, you watched it recently, or even if this is your first time seeing us, you know, my thing is honesty in giving you valuable information, useful, practical stuff. Now, the thing is I've been a full-time firearms instructor now for, man, coming up on 12 years. So I've done this full-time. This is how I support myself. This is how I put food on the table. This is how I earn a living. And I've done this now for well over a decade. And when you're dealing with an environment of people that come to you for help, you owe it to them to give them the best information possible. You owe it to them to give them accurate, useful, reliable information. And that's really what we pride ourselves on out here at the Ridge. Now, my background, military, law enforcement, and also, as I said again, over a decade of full-time firearms instruction experience. So I've got a nice, wide, varied background for this, and I've seen a lot of different trends come and go. Now, having written 3 books about the topic, you know, when you look at this from a historical perspective, you'll see that there's always a human tendency to buy that next Gucci piece of gear, or, oh, I need this just in case. It's kind of like having a toolbox filled with tools that only do like one specific thing. And rather than doing that, simplifying things, looking for things to add, we look at ways to strip everything down into its simplest, most distilled essence for you to kind of cut away at the confusion of a lot of this stuff. Now, I know there's a lot of stuff out there. There's a lot of people with a camera. Some of them have credentials, some of them don't. There's a lot of information out there, especially the last few years. Anybody with a camera and a gun collection all of a sudden becomes some kind of expert for whatever reason. But this isn't meant to disparage anybody in particular, and it's certainly not meant to be negative. But I will tell you this, you've got to have an honest conversation about yourself. What do you actually need to be successful during deadly force? And we're going to try to help you out in this. Now, for me, what it's all about is simplicity, but reliability. And when I look at things, we first of all need a reliable firearm. So there are quality manufacturers of firearms out there, pistol and rifle. You know, when we look at this, we don't want to buy the latest, greatest thing. You don't need to buy the most expensive thing in order to get the best quality. But we do need a simple, reliable firearm, whether that's pistol or rifle. Now, when it comes to that rifle, what do you need on it? Well, first and foremost, this rifle right here will solve the vast majority of problems for anybody that you're going to find yourself in. What's on it? A simple 2-point sling, a simple white light, a nice reliable set of iron sights that aren't going to move. And when we use this rifle, we can hone ourselves, train ourselves to a good degree. This rifle setup here, this style, has been doing work since the 1950s. And people across in all environments have used a rifle setup just like this to be in urban combat, to be in rural combat, suburban, cold, wet, hot climates, all that stuff, dusty environments, and they work. And this is a simple platform that we can use here. It's got everything on it that you need, nothing that you don't. On that same vein, similar concept. Notice the setup is the exact same. White light's in the exact same position. Once again, simple 2-point sling. This one here, we've still got iron sights on there, but we also have an optic if you wanted to add an optic, if you really, really wanted to. But once again, simple stuff. There's nothing crazy on there. I've got a sighting system. I've got an illumination system. I've got a retention system. That's what you need for a rifle. You don't need any other stuff on there. Everything that's on those rifles is Loctited on there so it won't rattle loose. And I know manufacturers out there will tell you, oh, you don't need a Loctite. Yes, you do. If it's got a screw on it, if it bolts onto your rifle in any capacity, you need blue Loctite on there so that it doesn't rattle loose. That means your scope rings. That means your optics mount. That means your flashlight mount. All the stuff that you have on there, you want to blue Loctite it. Keep it easy. Keep it simple. All right, now we can talk about stuff like when it comes to magazines. Like, how are you going to carry your magazines? Some guys like to have plate carriers on there. Some guys like to have a chest rig. Some people use a simple satchel. All those are fine, but I want you to ask yourself, somebody breaks in your house in the middle of the night, are you going to put your plate carrier on? Are you going to put your helmet on? Are you going to put all that stuff on in the time that somebody's running up the stairs to try to get you and your family or running throughout the house? No, we're going to grab our rifle and we're going to get to work. Now, when we look at this, let's look about possible versus plausible. Well, anything's possible. really. I mean, if you think about it, any scenario that you can imagine is possible. There's a whole industry out there designed to take advantage of your emotions and saying, oh, if you don't have this piece of gear, you're like out of it. You're totally compromised. But at the end of the day, we have to look at what's actually plausible. What is going to actually happen in there? How many rounds are you going to need in deadly force? Well, I can tell you from firsthand personal experience during Hurricanes Katrina and Rita down in New Orleans, I was there for several weeks, and I had one magazine in my rifle and three on my body. At no time during that entire situation was I afraid of running out of ammunition. At no time when I was down there was anybody else that was serving down there afraid of running out of ammunition, okay, on the street. So when you're dealing with stuff like this, guys, you got to have realism. I've got another friend who's in Mogadishu in the early 90s, actual real combat arms guy at the highest level, carried 6-7 magazines on him during that time. So you know, you really have to think about what's realistic versus what's possible, right? Anything's possible. And when the problem is that when guys start getting gear and they have like 8 mags, 9 mags, 10 mags on them, they got some on their chest rig or plate carrier, they got some on their legs and a drop leg, they've got all that stuff on their belt, you know, then we start adding weight to ourselves and adding unnecessary things. Same thing on your rifle. You know, there's guys that put all kind of heavy stuff on their rifle, grips and sights and all kind of stuff that's going to really be a detrimental thing for you because of the weight. You know, the more stuff that you got to carry, the less effective you're going to be, the less mobile you're going to be. Okay, so there you go. And I know there's guys out there who say, well, you just go to the gym a little bit more. Okay, well, I'm in my 40s. I still PT with guys, PT out there with guys half my age, no problem. And it's not a fitness thing. It's just, why would you want to fatigue yourself? Why would you want to do that? So be realistic in what you need. You know, to further illustrate this point, we can look at one of the most active conflicts in the world today, which is in Russia and Ukraine. Bad situation for everybody. It's not benefiting the world. And no matter which side of the aisle that you're on, or even neutral. And you look at this and you look at what the predominant stuff that's happening over there is going to be simple rifles with basic stuff. If you really look at the footage, most of the soldiers there on both sides, most of the fighters, they're not carrying a lot of stuff. They're not carrying craziness. So the predominant firearm over there is an iron-sided AK. So, you know, we really have to look at reality. And this is two modern armies facing off against each other. You know, what I'm telling you guys is that there's an entire industry out there that will sell you gear based on possibilities or the cool guy factor or whatever it is. Now, I don't know if you probably figured it out, what differentiates us from a lot of other firearms instructors out there is we're not going to tell you to buy a bunch of fancy crap or you need a bunch of gear because you don't. What you need is fundamentals and mental strength and resolve. And that's going to be the biggest ticket there is to be successful. Now, I'll tell you that I've seen the trends come and go over the decades. You know, 25 years worth of being on a firearm professionally in one way or shape or form or the other has shown me that the wheel goes round and round and round. And if you just grab a spoke, it'll be your turn next. You look at the stuff, pistol calibers, rifle types, all different kinds of optics. It's all going to go round and round and round. In my personal library of firearms books dating all the way back to the 1800s and maybe even before, I've got stuff in there, ideas at the time. And so what you're going to find is that there's going to be trends that ebb and flow. It's the coherence theory of truth. Oh, if everybody else is doing it, it must got to be the latest and greatest correct thing. That's not true. What's right is not always popular. What's popular is not always right. And when you look at yourself, you're going to realize that this is the most effective weapon that you have. This is the most effective weapon that you have. And that will is manifested through these. And what you have is the least important factor in being successful. So my advice is keep stuff simple. Invest your money on other things other than physical stuff. Invest your money in yourself. Invest in yourself to download that good software that's going to help you fight a lot better. So at this point in time, guys, I would really recommend that you focus on shooter development, invest in shooter development, invest in training techniques that's going to work for you rather than things. Because if you got that Tupperware of shame, you've got that bin of shame of the holsters, bag pouches, chest rigs that you don't use anymore but seemed like a real good idea a few years ago, you'll understand what I'm talking about. And so we're going to move this art forward. We're going to help provide proficient people out there that can protect themselves and their families. And that's what it's all about. If you found the information in this video helpful, go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Follow me on social media. That link is down below in the description box. And if you want to invest in yourself and you want to get some good training that's going to help you develop yourself as a shooter in the future, come on out to Valor Ridge and we can help you. This is Reid Henrichs of Valor Ridge reminding you the lessons that we learn are written on the tombstones of others. We'll see you on the ridge.